Hi everybody. I'll wait for a while till a couple of you flood in and then we'll get started. Hi Dharti, thank you so much for joining in. Hi Nidhi, much love to you. Pratibha, oh my god. Blue bird on the road. Wow, that's a nice handle by the way. Good one. So yes, guys, welcome to Awareness with Aditi, live show with me, Aditi Nagori. And today, after Himanshi, we have Dheeraj Murram Shetty, and he's going to join us today. Like I said, you don't have to have an NGO of yourself to do something for the society or something for people. You can just do it by normal being. Like, you don't have to have a company or an NGO. You can do it all by yourself. And that's what this man is all about. This man is an example of doing things all by himself. He works with different NGOs. All he likes to do is volunteer, do social work as much as possible. And trust me, you can't believe it's been more than 10 years that he's been doing it. 10 saal ho chuke hai. I am so surprised and so happy at the same time. Also, for a lot of people who are thinking, ki, acha, it's okay, we can also do it. Trust me, it's not that easy. Firstly, secondly, he's a banker by profession. So Monday to Saturday, apart from the second and fourth Saturday, he's been working and at the same time doing so much for the society, for the animals, for the welfare of each being possible. From education kits, school kits, to food donation, taking care of animals, stray animals, giving them food, even in this during this COVID situation, also they are doing these things. So I hope you understand that we don't need to have an NGO of our own, but we can be a volunteer and help and make a difference to so many lives. I'm just waiting for Dheeraj to join in and send me the request. But meanwhile, if you have any questions, you can talk to me. Ask me right here. Because today's topic is awareness on social need and social responsibility. When I say social, it's not socializing wala social. It is you, an individual, doing your work, your giving your time to something which is not just yours, but it's for everybody. Yes, can't wait for Dheeraj. Yes, me too. But Blue Bird on the road, what's your name? Hi Bhavik, how are you? Guys, he's an amazing photographer in Hyderabad. So people from Hyderabad, you know, if you need photography help, where to go? So I'm waiting. I don't know where is he. Meanwhile, any questions, guys? What am I doing? Why am I doing? On etc. etc. Hi, Sharanya. Thank you for joining in. I'm gonna call you after the live. Hey, Dheeraj is here, guys, and I'm waiting for him to send me the request. But like I said, today it's all about awareness on social need and responsibility. We all need to be socially aware. We all need to do our bit as much as we can. Like I said, donation is not the only thing you have to do. Sometimes, no donation, but still spending time, but giving them all the love. All the care you can makes a difference. I have experienced it. I personally do a lot of social work, and I didn't know ki, what can be done. So, what are the various ways to serve without the need of money? Very good question, Vikas, if that's your name. You're going to get all the answers for that as well. You can volunteer, you can get in touch with NGOs. You don't have to do much, just spend even 2 hours in the entire week. You can still be helpful for a lot of people. And more, we are going to have more questions and more answers. We are waiting for him to join in. Raja, can we know more secrets about you before knowing more secrets about Dheeraj? Yes, please let me know what you want to know. I'm an anchor by profession and trainer. And like I said, Dheeraj is all set. He's there with us. Can you guys hear us properly? Or is there any resound or anything? Please let us know.
Yes.
You're getting a resound?
Yeah.
Of my voice or your voice?
My own
My own voice.
So you'll have to use the headphones.
Or
We'll wait, no problem. Till then, Raja has asked me a few questions. I am going to answer that.
Is this okay now?
Hold on. I will also get done with Bluetooth because let's not risk our entire beautiful evening because I'm going to interview one of my closest friends and I don't want network to be playing a bad role for it.
Yes.
अच्छा अब रीसाउंड आ रहा है?
नहीं अभी नया आ रहा है, तो मेरा
आप लोग बताइए,
प्रॉब्लम है
किसी के भी फोन में प्रॉब्लम नहीं होता है धीरज, इट इज इंस्टाग्राम का प्रॉब्लम.
या
बिकॉज हे वी हैव गॉट गेटिंग अ लॉट ऑफ हाइज एंड हेलोस फॉर यू धीरज, तो एक बार सबको एक बार हाय भेज दो.
हाय हाय एवरीबॉडी.
So, for a lot of people, like I mentioned, Dheeraj is a banker by profession, but his passion, his choice of doing volunteering, of doing social work is never ending. It's been more than 10 years that he has done this, guys. So, let's get started with my first question, Dheeraj. How did you firstly realize that there is a social need or there is a social responsibility kind of a thing where you can do something or the other for the people? How did you realize that?
See, the thing is, like, we all say that, right? You need a support from everybody. It's like one person cannot do anything alone.
Correct.
Yeah, so one person cannot do anything alone. So that's when I thought, yeah, like, there are people, when I needed help or something like that, so there were few people with me. So I thought, like, yeah, somebody might also, unknown person probably, or like the known person might need help. So that's when I thought, like, yeah, it's like the world is together. So basically, it's like not an individual thing.
Correct. So yeah. There he means, guys, that whatever is happening, we're in this together. We are never individually in one problem. You take COVID or anything of that sort. So yes, that's absolutely right. That he got the understanding that, you know, when I wanted something, there are people. So when somebody wants me, I could also be there. And that's a very brilliant thought, Dheeraj. With this, I'm going to go to the next question. 10 years, Ipone, literally, Ivani chase to chase to. 10 years is a long time.
I didn't realize until like very recently when I got to know that like these Facebook and Instagram memories you keep getting, right?
Yeah.
So that's when I realized it's over 10 years, which when I started or something like that.
God. How do you feel doing 10 years of so much, you know, of course, you're doing your profession work, you got educated in these 10 years, you spent, you went to Kama Reddy, you came back, you're working in a bank, there's so much more, and you became friends with me, we'll get there,
yeah.
But 10 years, how do you feel? How do you feel giving 10 years of your life for something, such beautiful, ways of helping people? How do you feel?
I feel very great, actually. You know, the volunteering or the social responsibility kind of made me grow as a person, made me grow as an individual also. Like, I don't know, I started probably like when I was a teenager, like in my intermediate or something, like, you know, it just started as a, like group of friends and doing it as a, like what a normal weekend event or something like that. Then it started as a hobby. But now it's been so long and we've been doing it for so long. It's like, it's not a hobby anymore. It's a way of living, basically.
Yes, it becomes a routine, right?
Yeah, it's completely like, you think in that perspective. Okay, like when you
Correct.
Are doing something, okay, yeah, this might be something which is more beneficial to other person also. It's like, you know, mutual beneficial or mutual respect for everybody and towards a
Correct.
Society kind of.
Yes. For a lot of people, he doesn't do only for humans. He does it for humans, of course, but as well as stray animals. And he tries his bit in every possible way, guys. And we got a comment right here. I'm going to read that out. We have got that from Raja. He says, in today's date, we need a lot of social interaction. Dheeraj is one person who makes real people meet real people. Wow. Not sure how he is surviving in this lockdown though. By the way, in this lockdown also, he's doing a lot of work. We'll talk about that as well. Also remember, he is actually an essential service. By that, I mean that he's a banker and he goes to office every day, unlike you and me sitting in the house. And of course, we are stressed, no doubt about it, but they have some extra stress by themselves. They're bankers. They're going each day to bank. And at the same time, this man is doing something on weekends. So what are you doing on weekends? Please, I think now you should tell this to everybody. What are you doing on weekends, Dheeraj?
On the COVID weekends?
Yes.
Okay, on the COVID weekends, so basically, we are helping out a few stray animals. Like during the lockdown, all the shops and everything was closed down, right? So the
Correct.
Stray animals were not getting any food because the what do you say, the hotels were closed or the people were not wandering, so they are not throwing out anything. The dustbins are empty. Like there's nothing for the stray animals and all. So what
stray
I
animals,
thought
correct.
Was like, yeah. So what I thought was like, there's so many challenges coming up on Instagram and Facebook during the lockdown. Like,
yes.
So what I was thinking is, let's come up with something called Feed a Stray Challenge. So like,
wow.
Yeah, use social media for a good cause also. Like not different,
yes.
Different challenges. So like there's once upon a time there was an ice bucket challenge where people took an awareness thing for ice bucket challenge. So I thought like, yeah, let's come up with something called Feed a Stray Challenge where you can feed a single stray on that like you for. In your own locality, you don't have to go somewhere because again, lockdown,
absolutely.
Is basically you have to stick to your own place. So wherever, like opposite, like in near your house or downstairs of yours, in your lane, locality, something like that. So you
correct.
Probably can feed a stray. And so that's how I started it. And then we realized that there was an Usmania University very nearby, like hardly like 1.5 kilometers from my place. And the entire university,
yeah.
it's closed. There was no there's no college. So the hostels, the canteens, and it's all closed. And it's like a mini, mini forest kind of thing, you can say. It's a very big,
absolutely. It's beautiful and green. I am from Hyderabad too. Got educated there. My exam forms are from Usmania University. I get that.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So there were around like 100 to 150 dogs there, and like there
wow.
were some cows and cats, and also like, yeah, the group of friends, we thought like, why not, like, okay, we are doing it anyways, in the streets and all, they are providing something. So I thought like, let's take permission from the GHMC and all, so that they will also come feed the strays in the daytime or in the evening time, because evening again 7 o'clock you have to be home. So they can take
correct,
up in
absolutely.
The evenings, and you can go in the mornings, and you can serve the stray dogs there. So yeah, that's how we've been feeding for the stray dogs in Usmania University.
Wow.
And it's been today, it's been more than 50 days. So last Sunday it was
correct.
50, so probably, yeah, today would be like 57 or 58 days since
yeah.
we are doing.
So in short, for all the people out here, all the dog lovers, all the animal lovers, in the weekends, Dheeraj, apart from doing Monday to Friday or sometimes Saturday as well as for us, because, you know, Saturday is only second and fourth are holidays for banks. He actually spends his weekend by going and volunteering and doing so much for the stray animals, giving food. And I see all these posts every day where he gets rice and so much more. I mean, I'm not saying he do as much as he is doing, guys. But what I'm trying to tell you is do as much as you can do. You know, that's very important. Like, Dheeraj, even I'm very scared of dogs. You know that for a fact. So what I try and do is that when there is extra food in the... Or is I try making extra food every day, thoda thoda. So you can just go and put niche. You know, aapke khud ke locality mein, in your locality, you'll find more than 10-15 dogs. You just need to give them food. So
yeah.
Understand, guys, like we are used to animals on the road. I think dogs also need us, right?
Yeah, so basically what I was trying to say is the way you are scared of, for the dogs, like my mom is an allergy patient, so she can't, I cannot have pet. Imagine I'm a pet lover and all,
I understand.
Because like, yeah, because of the allergy issues and we are not supposed to have fur at our places, the dust and all, so I'm not supposed to. But so that gave me another opportunity, like see, when you show love to one single pet, it becomes yours. But when you don't have a pet, like all the stray animals are your pets.
Absolutely. I think you've told it very well, yeah. By the way, we are getting a lot of comments. You're amazing. Your true motivation. A lot of hearts for you. Thank you, Sonam, for joining in. Sonam Chhabra is a brilliant anchor, guys. And she herself does a lot for animals, especially dogs, adoption alerts and everything. She does it from Delhi. But yes, I just wanted to let you know, if you know somebody in Delhi and there is time when you get to know that you need help, contact her. All right, my next question. Okay, weekends are all sorted this time for animals. But apart from animals, you've done a lot of things, right? So could you please share what all you've done? 10 years is a big number. Thoda, let's recap your journey.
So during the COVID time, basically, I could not give my physical presence, which already I was exposed to too many people at the bank because of the the direct DBT benefit transfer, there were huge crowds in the bank. So I was already exposed to too many people. So I could not give my physical presence in the wallet. I didn't want to put the other volunteers also at risk, because you never know if you're asymptomatic or like you have no idea.
You never
know. So I thought like, let them, they are doing their own work. So let's not disturb them. But there is some like any event, you need a background help also. Where like raising funds or like sharing the poster or reaching out to other people, calling the resources. So yeah, I was handling that department for the COVID section. So you can say that. And as for the 10 years, I don't even remember when I started. As I said, I started when I was a teenager. So yeah, like a group of school friends, actually, like a group of school friends, we started it like... as far as I remember or I recollect, it was probably a Christmas event. We were kids basically, and we wanted to distribute chocolates for the kids in the orphanages. It very nearby school, so hardly like one or two orphanages we had in our like the school ka area or the college ka area. So we took up them and we started distribute. Like we thought we'll go and distribute. Then we realized like we took up around like 300 or 400 chocolates, but then it's like in a moment they all got finished.
Jiffy, absolutely.
In the moment they all got finished, then I realized actually, well, like, you know, they don't get all these things daily. So it's like it's a privilege for them when somebody comes. It's like, you know, it's an overwhelming feeling when they say, thank you. Like, I've been waiting for this chocolate, or like, today's Christmas. Like, okay, hamara Santa aa gaya. All those things kind of.
Bahut pyar milta yaar.
Yeah, so that's when I thought like, okay, I have to do this more often. Like, you know, that gives a self-satisfaction. Like,
definitely.
I have to do this, like, we have to do this more often. And then gradually we started doing more events and all. And after
could
that...
Could you share
like,
a few of your events? I don't want you to like name the NGOs and all, because I know that you've worked with a lot of NGOs, and taking out few names and forgetting few names will be a big problem. But yes, you've done different events. School kids?
School kids and all came like hardly like 5-6 years ago when I started with a different NGO. Like after this, my place two, I actually graduated in Tamil Nadu. So when I went there, for my graduation in Tamil Nadu, I was like, again, like, you know, all the people are doing working here. Like we have a team here who is doing it. And then all of a sudden you landed up somewhere where you have no idea where to start. Everything is from the scratch again. So that's when like, then again, I came across something called in a college newspaper, they were doing some charity event. So I saw that like when other friends and all, they started doing it. I came across that. I contacted them. And then, we started doing it in the college. I was volunteering for one NGO where we had four different projects. Like we adopted a school in the nearby the college. So most of the college students were the day hostlers and very few for the day scholars. So we adopted a tiny school there nearby the college. It's a very huge college. So I thought we started teaching there. And instead of teaching the normal other volunteers and all, just go teach and all. So we came up something with Unschool. Unschool is basically, for example, you say magnetism, instead of showing them in the books or like South Pole, North Pole. No, you don't do that. You practically get the two magnets and you show them this is North Pole and this is South Pole. They repel, they don't repel. So that's how practical knowledge is something called Unschool, without any curriculum kind of. And daily events or daily knowledge for the kids and all. Yeah, so that was one event which we came up in the college. And then birthday Santa kind of like we see in the college, like so many people celebrating birthdays, huge university and so many people celebrating birthdays. So like we came across few people like the kids, chote chote bache, they are like suffering with cancer or like HIV and all those things. They didn't have like too much lifespan. Like we thought like make a wish kind of project. So what we were thinking, say, Santa, like we took up
wishes
their
pure karenge. Chote chote
wishes pure karenge. We thought that. But then again, the funds ka thing. So what we thought is like who is celebrating the birthday in the college, make sure that 50% goes for the celebration and 50% goes for the same celebrations, but as the kid.
For different ways. Kid.
So different ways. So yeah, so that is where when you started going for the different orphanages and all, you realized that many people donate old like old clothes and all that, or like the blankets or and all that. But what we came across is that these kids and all, they have internal rashes and all. So what they wanted basically is innerwears. And not the donated innerwears. They require new innerwears. They don't even have a habit of wearing innerwears and all.
In a way,
So
absolutely, I get it.
then we thought like let's teach them hygiene first. Let's teach them hygiene first, and let's make sure
That's
they have
brilliant.
a habit of innerwears. And also we collected few data and all from the different orphanages nearby, or like the homes nearby. And then we raised funds and. Tamil Nadu, right? So the Tirupur is a basic factory outlet of where you get all the clothing.
Yeah.
And so then we purchased innerwears for them. We covered almost the entire around like 1,000 homes of Tamil Nadu, and then
Wow.
Few sections of Bangalore and few in Hyderabad. I belong to Hyderabad, so whenever we come in the holidays,
Yeah.
like the semester holidays, so you cover some in the Hyderabad also.
Hyderabad as well, yes.
Yeah, so the new Nikas project, so that was one. So that was all in the college. So once you graduated from the college, and again the chapters gets closed. So the juniors take up
Yeah.
that particular thing, because you won't be there anymore. So we handed over our projects for the juniors, and then again I came back to Hyderabad. So that's when I landed with other NGOs, the two different NGOs called Youth for Seva and Youngistan. And then
Correct.
they have a huge what do you say, the volunteer base and huge events. Like
Absolutely.
when you see their events, you get to know that actually there's so much requirement, so many events are happening
Correct.
around you. Yeah, so then yeah,
Yes.
the Youth for Seva, we
We have
started
a lot of comments, Dheeraj. A lot of people are asking, what is the secret of your energy, boss? Kya khate ho, kya peete ho, boost ha? There are comments that boost is the secret of your energy. I think Kaushik, if I'm not wrong, I met Kaushik, right? If I am not wrong, have I?
Yes,
Yes.
yeah. If it is the same question, yeah, you have met him.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if there are different. It's a common name, so I'm sure और भी हो सकते हैं. A lot of people are literally telling that you have actually boosted their energy. You made them realize that they can also do something in terms of helping in different ways, चाहे वो education हो या animals हो या कुछ भी हो. So I think we all owe you a lot of thanks because you have inspired a lot of people. I remember how it feels like being inspired. So I know that 10 years where you have done a lot of things and we cannot finish all that discussion in an hour's time. So I'm going to go to the next question, Dheeraj. What do you think is the social need and social responsibility people should have right now? What do you think is important? E time lo, aim jayal janalu.
So basically, like you have to be everybody knows the scenario outside, right? The what do you
Correct.
call COVID scenario. So all you have to do is like be kind to fellow person, and take precautions, whatever the necessary precautions, because it's asymptomatic, dude. Most of the time, the 90% of the cases are asymptomatic. So you never know. You might be the carrier, but you never know about it.
Yeah,
So
I
yeah,
agree.
so take all the precautions and just be kind. There's lots of unemployment happening, and there's lots of migrants moving around.
Oh,
Like
yes.
at your home, you might be having a maid who's struggling to do like struggling for like financial help, or like the groceries help. It can be
Yeah,
any
please
help.
have a
Like
check.
just please have a check. Like lots of the help, whichever you want to do, is around you. You
Yeah,
just
you don't
have
have to go anywhere.
to check. You don't have to go anywhere. There's lots of help which is
Just
required around
yeah.
surrounding you.
Just
Just
talk to
be
the
kind.
right person. Yeah, talk to your neighbors. How are they doing? Talk to your maid. I know she might not be coming. I think things are open in Hyderabad. I'm living in Mumbai right now, and there's majorly nothing open, and we still don't have maids or anything. It's important that you have a check with them, your watchmen, the dogs around you, the cats around you. I think brilliant point. But apart from that, if COVID is not the situation, see, COVID is a situation which will go one or the other day. But in general, what are the responsibilities people should have, like you said, be kind. I think it's very important that everybody chooses to be kind. You know, it's very easy to say be kind, but I think it's important that you choose. So is there anything else you would want to add in Kemana Okaron points, if you remember?
I mean, the Mother Earth is not for you or me alone, it's for the coming generations also. So whatever you do, just be respectable towards the Mother Earth and just be kind. I mean, like you never know, like probably you might die and you might get rebirth also. I believe in the concept of rebirth, so you might rebirth. So if you spoil the earth today, you might be the victim tomorrow.
You never know.
You never know. So yeah, just be kind and be protected towards the Mother Earth. Just take care. That's all.
I remember, how did we meet, Dheeraj? Because it's been now it's quite some time that we've met. How did we meet?
So, memory check. Yeah. Do you remember or yeah, just asking me?
I am asking you. I remember a little bit of it, of course. We had a conversation like a day before, so I do remember. But it is so beautiful, no? That how you meet like-minded people when you start doing things towards society.
So I was teaching for something called NMMS in Eramanjal School, if you remember. You remember the Panjagutta Eramanjal School in
Hyderabad? Yes.
So NMMS is a project. You get the scholarship for the government school so that they don't discontinue.
Correct.
So we have been teaching for the kids and all. And then I saw a performance, like the kids were performing, practicing there probably for August 15th or
Independence Day.
Because the exam is in November and we were teaching around July ending. So probably it should be for August Independence Day celebration. So then I came across, I thought like they were doing an outstanding job. So I asked them like, who taught them? Then there's one more volunteer Akka has come and she was teaching the dance for her. Is she here? So that, then the teacher came in and I thought this is a volunteer. She's teaching us the dance and I thought we are doing for the different schools and all. If you're volunteering and if you might be interested in volunteering, we can teach, but I cannot dance. So I thought somebody who knows dance.
But now you dance, huh? Now so I heard you're a dancer as well. The things are changing for Dheeraj.
Somebody who is a dancer can probably teach them for the other in the other schools also, so that they can also exhibit their own talent. Yes. It's not just the the mind thing or let's get them social or the other dance acting and all. So that's when I thought probably I'll ask you. So that's when I actually reached out to you.
Yes, Krishna says every Sunday he's a dancer. And I know that, guys, because again, there also we went through, I mean, Aryan is very common to both of us. But like I said, guys, even we met through, NGO related work. I mean, NGO was not the way. I was a freelancer and I did whatever I wanted to do for the society. So here, why we're talking about how we met is that maybe he was associated with an NGO and he did things. Maybe you are not associated with NGO, but you can still do things. If you have a talent, you can teach that to children. You have no idea how happy they will be to dance, to learn how to talk, to be so confident that, I know.
Like 10 years of volunteering, when you started teaching kids for the NMMS, they are they finished their NMMS and they came out of the school, they graduated and now they're coming back as volunteers. They're coming back as volunteering and teaching their own school kids. Like when the competition happens, they take it as a personal inspiration. Like whatever you talk and everything, it makes an impact in their own life. They
absolutely.
Not just the movie heroes or somebody, the volunteer can also be a role model for the people.
100% yes.
100%.
When I went Make a Difference, I'm sure you might know about it. When I went through them for the dream camps, to teach dance and stuff like that. Yaar, in un bachcho ka pyar na, the level of love they give you. And they literally treat you like a celebrity, okay? I'm not denying this. Literally, they'll come, talk to you, want a picture with you, want to just, they have the fear of even talking to you. So much love you get from them. Please add up.
In the college, okay, I never knew Tamil. I graduated in Tamil Nadu. So I never knew Tamil when I was teaching the kids and all. So when I didn't come, one Sunday or one particular weekend when I missed, so the kids used to be like, where is the English Anna? Where is English Anna? We are missing English Anna. So that's
happened with me too.
So that's
it feels so nice.
They you come up the next day, then they ask you, like, why didn't you come last weekend? Like,
now yeah,
you
have they to do.
Yourself. Like, they are like, they are yeah. all associated with you. They want pictures with you. They like, they do what? They imitate you.
Yes. They try to act like you. They try to have the hairstyle like you. They, you are no less than a celebrity for them. Yeah. You are the heroes for them, you know, who kind of, you know, in different ways. You can teach them, you can feed them, you can educate them. You can teach them talent-related activities like dance, skating, or whatever you can. But the point is that they will love you.
Yeah, if you think that it is like you won't be able to help through dancing, teaching, or anything as such, you know, the probably that home requires something. So maybe you can help them financially also.
Yes. And if you can't help financially, then you have other options as well. Other like options, if you have time and you can pay it up. So just to sum up, guys, till now, there are a few things socially which are very important to do. One is, you, instead of saying be kind, everybody feels it's so preachy and so gyani, say that I will choose to be kind. Let's actually be kind towards animals. Let's actually be kind towards humans. And for a fact, let's be kind to every being. Just don't sum it up with humans. Every being is important. Plants ho, nature ho. I think you also did sapling, this thing as well.
Yeah, so basically voluntary is something like when you go vote, right? So when the voting is what? Like you are expecting something from the society. You want this particular society to be there. So for 5 years, you do it like you vote for only once. But when you volunteer, you are building up a society where you want to live in every day. Yeah. So that's voluntary. Like you are actually building your own society where you want to be. So just be a change.
And it's not easy, guys. You know, it's easy for us to try and wanting to help, but for them, it's a very new thing. Even, you know, when I did this Telangana and Andhra, they had the social welfare schools, the colleges and schools, social and tribal welfare. So I was teaching them a personality development in English language for like 20 days. You have no idea when I went. My then boyfriend and now husband, he came to pick me up on the last day. When I went by, no, jitne bhi bacche the, jitne bhi students the, they are all 11, 12 standard students. They ran behind the car till they couldn't see the car, yaar. They made handmade, you know, wo udhar jungle hota hai na, medak side, that, all that. Yeah. So they make these beautiful bouquets out of out of the leaves and all these yellow chote flowers and all. Oh my God, that love. So how do you digest so much love? Because I'm sure you get much more love than anybody can get, huh? How do you digest it?
So basically, like, as I said, what you give is what you get.
Yeah, you need to give love, you need to get love.
So when you don't expect anything and if you get something, it's an overwhelming feeling. So you know, that motivates you. When you get so much love, I have to do more. That motivates you. That levels up your own threshold.
Confidence. Always you want to do more.
More like abhi to like okay, you help 25 kids, are 25 logo se itna khushi mil raha hai. What if you help 50 kids? What if you help 100 kids? So whenever you have
like, and one more thing, take social media to your advantage. You know, since this is my fourth episode, guys, my first two episodes were on mental health, and more than 1,000 people had got benefited with it. I can't believe that I could do it just because of Instagram and doing this live. I have no idea of, you know, when I started, I was like, "Arey, I don't know what will happen." And today, people come up to me and say that, "Aditi, when do we have the next session?" When I'm doing my second live also for the day, people are coming to watch. People are waiting to listen. Dheeraj ki story, Himanshi ki story, Ritu ki story. I think that is amazing, right? So, guys, please use your social media accounts in a right way to kind of, you know, help.
Like, it's not just following your friends or something. Like, use it for a better way also. Like, you are following your friends, you're doing something. Like, probably you can do the
same. I have a question.
Yes.
Yeah, I have this question. I personally also have this problem as well. That, you know, a lot of, like, you post a lot of things on social media when you do anything for that matter. Okay, I'm totally opposite and you know that. I do everything and nobody gets to know. Because maybe from my childhood, I was being told that, you know, do good work and keep it to yourself. You know, do help people and don't tell that you help people. Otherwise, it's like you're showing off. But you know, Dheeraj, this is not the case with you. You do not, you've still been posting so much, 10 years say. So why do you post so much? Is it actually a show off or what do you think it is?
So what I feel is like, yeah, they say that when you do it with the right hand, the left hand should know about something, the good thing and all. But what I feel is when the right hand is something, let the left hand also know about it and let the left hand also do the same thing.
Interesting.
So that's my, I feel, and I've been doing it. And, you know, yeah, as you said, people thought like when I was started volunteering, like when I was a teenager, you know, that's the age.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Inside, like what is happening? Okay, he's doing for this or that something. When it's like the time goes by and when you're doing it every day, daily, weekend, then it's, there's no point as people already get to know you. Like you are doing, correct. If you're doing it for the name of fame, you won't stop. Like you will stop it at one particular when you feel that you get satisfied with the fame. But this thing is you never get satisfied. Like, like it's always something which motivates you. When you start doing it and when people say, when you post it or something, like take an example, like when you start I was feeding during the COVID and all. I started feeding animals. So as you said, the people who were scared of dogs or like the people who are scared of their own street animals and all, they realized the need. Like, yeah, now there's nothing open. The dogs are like the street animals, the cats, the dogs, the cows, the pigs, they're all suffering. And it was hot summer. So like, like when you give them like the ideas, like put some water bowl in the your own terrace, the birds will feed. When you put a ball at the, when you put a water ball in the, what do you call, in front of your grid, the stray animal, like they get, they'll feed on that.
To drink water.
So, yeah, so it's like you are motivating them. When you do that, people get inspired. So people also tend to do that. So, yeah, like it, every coin has two sides, right? No, so this is my perspective. This is what I feel.
So, and I rightly agree with this, Dheeraj, because I used to not post, and you know that very well, because you met me when I was in Thomson Reuters, I think.
Yeah.
And that is 2013, 2014, I think, if I'm not wrong. I don't remember the years now. But the point is, that's more than 5-6 years, okay? I didn't know that, by the way. Oh. I'm sorry. I didn't know. I was so clueless about it. So, the point is that, you know, I realized that if you upload, if you post, it does help people. But the point is, if you're genuinely doing work and then posting it, it's more important. You know, rather than just trying to do one day and then post it 101 times, you can probably do more and, you know, post as well so that that post could inspire. Because I remember seeing your Instagram stories of people saying that, thanks, Dheeraj, for making us realize this. Thanks, Dheeraj, you inspired us. Thanks, Dheeraj, even I did this for my stray dogs. I mean, that's commendable. So for a lot of people who ask me this question that a lot of people post so much on social media, it's okay. If you want to see the post, see. If you don't want to, you know, there is one thing. You can just touch that and it goes to the next story. You can do that. So I'm thanking.
Volunteering is something like you don't serve alone. You make others also serve with you.
Yes. Volunteering is like that. It's selfless work. Yeah. What are you getting out of it? But honestly, they say it is selfless work. Trust me.
Make others also have the happiness. Yeah. Make others also realize
I do it. I do it because end of the day, no, I get so much love. I don't even sometimes feel ki mummy papa bhi zarurat hai. Itna pyar to ye log hi de dete. You know, these kids, these adults, the orphanages, the people at the old age home, they are like, yeah, dada dadi yaar. I mean, for me, I call them also, dada dadi.
I can add one more point for this thing. Like, you know, so many people want to help and so many people want to do, but they don't have a medium or they don't know how to do it or the way to start kind of thing. So correct. When you do something, like when in your own friend circle start doing this and when they start doing it, they will get connected to you. Like, I want to do this, but I don't know where to start. So they will get connected to you and probably second or third day, they will join you. And that's my case for a very long time. And that's been happening with me from very long time.
Correct. So for a lot of people who ask this question, there is no harm if you post it. But all I want to say is be genuine, do generally help karo aur fir post karo aur bahut log ko inspire karo yaar. Aisi cheezo mein you need to inspire people. So post as much as you want. There is no harm. It's not wrong. If people think that you're doing show off, let them think. Kuch to log kahenge, logo ka kaam hai kehna. You can't change it.
Yeah, who has a good intent, they don't even worry about it. Like whether the people take it negatively, they don't even worry. अरे already your बच्चों से या or whatever the doing deed activities है उनमें उसको कुछ मिल रहा है, so this thing doesn't matter.
And trust me, it doesn't matter. Even in the COVID situation, there are a lot of people who are trying to do so much, no matter what, be it food, be it donating money. If you can't go out, like, see, in Mumbai, I really can't go out everywhere. So I do my bit in my own way. वैसे ही आप हैदराबाद में जा सकते हो, करो. आप बैंगलोर में जा सकते हो, करो. आप अगर नहीं जा सकते, if you're in some पहाड़ी एरिया like लद्दाख and all of that, yes, there are certain restrictions which is acceptable. But the point is, do your bit. Do your bit. Nobody can stop you. But one person can always stop you. That is your parents. They won't stop you because you're doing a good work, okay? Their concern is not that you're doing good work. But when you start as a teenager, because I and you started when we were teenagers, you remember? Padhai kar le, bahar jaake kya milne wala hai? Chadukoch gada intlo. Paitikali em chestunna asala? So how did you deal with your parents, yeah? How did you handle them and make them understand ki mummy? Then it just na, daddy. Then it just na. How did you do that?
Basically, as I said, I started as a teenager. So I started as a teenager during the last stage of the intermediate chapter or like the plus two chapter. So that time I had the pressure, and that was just time. It was a hobby, like not the regular volunteering or like not all the weekends kind of thing. So I used to when I realized like when there were exams and all, then I'm not taking up anything. When I had exams, like it's not just to help the
create
other
a thing. Balance.
You need to create a balance. You need to help yourself also. Like you have to, like once you are in a respectable position, you might be able to help more people.
You never know. Yeah, so absolutely agreed. Yeah.
Yeah. So yeah, you have to make sure that you are also in a respectable position. Make sure you create that impact for yourself first, and then go for it. So I went up to Tamil Nadu. Then there was no stopping because it was a hostel.
Yeah, that's one good thing. I think it really helps. Na, staying a little away from family for some time does help. I don't mean it this way that you do it forever, guys. Your parents need you more than anybody else. I'm married and I miss my mother every single day. I just want to go be with her. But life was a little different. So I had to be away from that in a very, very younger age. So I literally feel sometimes ki, you know, we should be there for our parents. Okay. By the way, a lot of people are literally commenting, saying that you're true inspiration. Good to hear from you, etc., etc. Matlab jaate hi ja raha hai. Sirisha madam is also my favorite person. She also helps me. Okay, great. That's great. You're a kind-hearted person, which is a good compliment. Yeah, bahut kam kind log hote hai na. But I think we should all choose to be kind. Yeah, I think it's all learning. Na? How you learn to write? How you learn to read? How you learn to walk? We need to learn to choose to be kind. We need to, you know, practice it. Okka rojulo edi avvadu kabatti practice cheyalasinde tappadu. My next question to you is, which is a very important question I've got from audience. How do you raise funds? Sometimes I've seen that, you know, when you send me the links, the amount is already so close. 10 lakh ka hota hai, to bhi ho jata hai. 5 lakh ka hota hai, to bhi ho jata hai. How do you raise so many funds, yeah?
So, just through the social media, as which you are mentioning, use social media for a good cause, yeah. Like, you might reach so many people. Like, when you have friends in the physical presence, you might reach to very limited people. You might know physically only like 50 people, 100 people. You might not be able to contact with them every day. But social media is a platform. Like when you put up a single post, there will be like hundreds and thousands of people watching
like
it.
This.
So that's where this thing comes up. Like when you've already been helping it, when you've already been volunteering for regularly, when you post things about it, when the necessity comes, they're always ready to help you.
Yeah.
So that's where,
I agree.
Like, so yeah, that's how like the funds raising was never a problem. Like people have been always seeing my posts and all. They're always ready to jump in. They're always ready to not just the fans.
I think you've made that place. You've made that place for yourself, Dheeraj, that, you know, remember, I used to save your name as Dheeraj Banker, dude, and used to be like, pehle Dheeraj youngest than tha. And then you used to tell me, ki, what is this? Now we are friends. So I realized that you do create a special place for yourself in people's heart. And I think that is commendable. For a lot of people who are from my profile and hashtags, please follow Dheeraj. His ID is changed right now, so I don't remember. Please tell what's your Instagram ID because I don't remember.
It's I am M. Dheeraj.
I am M. Dheeraj. So you can please go follow him. Show all the love because he's genuinely doing so much work, guys. I'm so proud of him. He's younger to me, so I can say this, that I'm so proud of him. Otherwise, I have to think about it. But yes, it's amazing to see such brilliant people coming up and doing such great work. My next question, also before that, you can follow me as well as him. Him on @ I am M. Dheeraj. You can follow me on Aditi Nagori Official. That's my name. All right. My next question and the last question for the day is, it's very important because I see that you have a vision, okay? You have a clarity, HALE, how you can help people. And you always want to do something or the other more. And you're not that person who can stop at one level. You always want to do one step aage, aur aage, aur aage. I could see that. I don't know. I might be wrong, but that's my feeling. So I want to know, what's your vision for our country? What's your vision for our country?
So not just country, you can say. As I said, it's Mother Earth is and all the place. And you don't restrict yourself.
Absolutely. Correct.
Like place. So like the volunteering work which we are doing, the NGOs and all. My aim or like my wish is that none of the NGOs should be there. That meant that the necessity should not be there. The necessity for the NGOs should not be there. When you take care of yourself, when you take care of your own surroundings, when you're being kind for your own surroundings, there won't be any necessity. So that's a great thought. That's a long.
It's time taking, but it's not impossible. It's possible. So guys, this is what I'm talking about. This man is not just a banker, but he has thoughts of next level. I mean, just think about it. All the 30 people watching us, did you think that we can have a place like something like this in the world when there is no NGOs, no non-profit organization? Did you think about it? I'm sure 99% ne nahi socha hoga. This is what I'm talking about, guys. All you need to do is think on something and work towards it. I'm super proud. We are getting a lot of compliments. I'm missing it out. So many comments are like, da 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 da. He always inspires us. He does social service to next level. But one question from the audience is, political entry kortara? Eltara politics lo?
No, definitely not. I am not interested. Yeah, I mean, like when you are in the system, bringing the change is a little bit easier. But I am not a political person. Like, you know.
No, I agree. I'm not either. I'm not going to think about it also. But you know, there are a lot of people who are asking ki next PM nuve aita hu, next MLA in your area, Ramnagar, right? If I'm not wrong, next Ramnagar ka MLA is Dheeraj. And I think it's not impossible for the amount of work you do. I think you just have to go to the right direction, but provided you want to do it. Okay, audience, any questions? Any questions for Dheeraj? Politics gurunchi, he already gave the answer. He's not interested. Interest lenappudu manam em cheyalem kabatti light iskundam. Let's ask him, Anna, please, Anna. Rajiv, Vivek, he's not at all a political person. Yes, Anika, I know that. I very well know that. 5 to 6 years I've been knowing him. He will not get into politics until and unless he gets a scope of really changing everything in the present situation. I mean, I'm not talking about BJP and Congress. Please don't get there, guys. All I'm trying to say is that how things are getting better, it could be much better later in life. How do you manage your time? One common question everybody is asking. How do you manage your time? No travel chesto, family to time space chesto, bank lo pan chesto, trekking chesto, volunteering chesto, malli kudurte nannu kalavadaniki vasto. I am like in next corner of the city in Hyderabad. Nu nannu kalavadam kuda vasto weekend lo, malli parties kuda chesto. Etla chesto babu? How do you manage time, Mr. Dheeraj Murram Shetty? The nation wants to know.
So, I never had to struggle for it. Like, as I said, like, you know, like, you have a, you know, where you just can manage. Like, if I have to tell you that I'm meeting, you know, like 4 to 5, when I already have an event or something, then I will not be meeting you, but probably I'll be meeting you next weekend or something like that, or I'll postpone that. Like, you just have to manage with your friends. I'm thankful that all my support, I have a supportive friends, and all the events also. Like, there were times where when I had to go for an a trek, as you said, like I love treks and all. But then when it's all priority basis.
I love it too.
Yeah, so like there was an NGO event which is happening. It's an annual event which is happening. So
I remember.
You know your own priorities, so you don't go for it. Like you, when you know your priorities, when you have to know, probably like this is an annual event. You have to make sure that your presence is required here. So yeah, you'll be here.
After Brilliant the event
thought. Next weekend or after that, then you might go for the traveling thing.
Yes.
Or you might cover it up later.
Yes, guys, I think it's all about time management. It's about you prioritize what you want to do. And for a lot of people, they are also asking you, when are you going to get married, by the way, Dheeraj? That's a very question. But yeah. Cheskuntadu bhai, tondar enduku meeku? Asal, I have this question. Enduku tondari?
So there's so many viewers, like find someone who is like who's same like-minded. Yeah, like I'm always open for it.
Yes, and I think like-minded people milna mushkil hota hai, you know, so you have to work on that. And I'm sure he knows a lot of like-minded people, and then he'll be wondering she's married and or she's having a boyfriend already. So you know, life is a struggle, people. It's struggle. Okay. Wait, and for a lot of there's one more question, by the way. They say that పెళ్లి చేసినాక సోషల్ సర్వీస్ ఆపుతావా? ప్లీజ్ కంటిన్యూ సోషల్ సర్వీస్ ఈవెన్ ఆఫ్టర్ మ్యారేజ్. వై దిస్ క్వశ్చన్?
So I've been getting this, not just that, like, so as you said, no, I've been one for since young age. So people were like, I was in Hyderabad, so I've been taking up volunteering and all. So once you go to the I went to the Tamil Nadu, so then you moved a different place, so you might not be volunteering, your volunteer ends here. So that's what people might be thinking.
Yeah.
But as you said, like, what's your mindset in, or what is your point of interest? So we started up there, we started volunteering then, and after the graduation is done, then you came back to Hyderabad, but it's a long gap of 4 years, so you have to start from scratch. And also people might be thinking, college is done, the volunteering is done, you will be stopping it. But no, I did not stop. Again, I started continuing after coming back to Hyderabad.
Brilliant.
Then, after education, you started like I started working. I was posted 150 kilometers all the way from Hyderabad.
Yeah, Kamareddy used to still come, used to do social service, used to work with NGOs, used to meet us, your friends. I mean, hats off. And I think for a lot of people who are talking ki marriage ke baad cheeze badal jaati hai, you've swapped, I mean, your camera.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah. A lot of people asking things change after marriage. Honestly, it depends on you. It's your individual choice as well. You need to either discuss it out with your partner or, you know, make it straightforward. Like, I mean, I'm telling it because I'm living this life. I was like this before marriage. Ask Dheeraj because he knows me. I am like this even after marriage. I do social service when I want to do. I do dance when I want to do. I work when I want to do. But it's all about you as a choice.
Where I dragged you and also Avinash to the NGO events too.
Yeah. So my husband is total introvert. Not interested in media, doing this. Nahi hota hai. Hum IT wale, hum kaam karenge, bas itna interest hai. But the point is that it is your individual choice. Marriage cannot be the reason of you dropping out on your passion. For Dheeraj, volunteering is a passion. It's a routine. It's in his blood now.
It's impossible.
It's a way of living. And please, I think this is a problem in our country that we always blame marriage or something or the other, you know, if something is not happening. I think it's individual's choice. It's never a marriage. It's never a breakup. It's never a loss. It's always a priority. I hope I answered this question as well, guys. Okay, next question for you. I think your questions are not going to end, huh? People are saying 2020 is the end, Dheeraj. What is your thoughts on it? Quick, I think we'll have to finish in 5 minutes, so quickly.
The people said 2012 was also end, but it never.
Yeah, it didn't. So, correct. Who inspired you?
Sorry?
Who inspired you? Who is your inspiration? Some or the other people in some or the other way.
Yeah, the basically it's like people inspire you at every moment. Yeah, like at different levels, different people. Family might be inspiring you, or like where the volunteering you teach, the kids can also be the inspire.
Definitely, kids are always.
They can also be an inspiration. Your friends can also be an inspiration, or like lots of people and lots of inspirations. I cannot take single names.
Yeah, and if you take single names and if you don't take my name, you'll be banned. So it's okay. You better don't take names.
So yeah,
Krishna says. Yeah. Emano. Chappu chappu. Manchi matter jatte chappali.
So you also inspired me in like I've been telling you, no, like different people inspire you on different topics.
Absolutely.
So you
different
also
things.
Inspired me. Like you also inspired me to take up dance, and also like when there is something which you're not able to do, when you're doing it and you enjoyed that feeling of teaching the kids and all. So maybe like if I learn dance and if I'm also able to teach, I might also get that happiness feeling. So yeah, you
100%
take up that inspiration.
Dance is expression, yaar.
Yeah, so that's what I took inspiration from you and Aryan actually for that.
Yeah. By the way, a lot of people are asking. I'm telling basically. Anduke love marriage chesukovali basically anta. And they are also asking that. Oh my God! So many questions. Yeah. Inni years ayipoyinayi social service ivanni chestunavu. Ammai dorakaleda. Didn't you find a girl of your type or your mind? Arey, I gave the answer already, guys. Yaar, kyu usko pareshan kar rahe ho? చెప్పాడు కదా ఆల్రెడీ ఐదర్ ద గర్ల్ ఇస్ మ్యారీడ్ ఆర్ ద గర్ల్ ఇస్ ఎంగేజ్ ఏం చేస్తాడు కాంట్ బ్రేక్ దెమ్ అప్ నో కమ్ ఆన్ యా పీపుల్ డోంట్ గెట్ మ్యారేజ్ అండ్ లవ్ నౌ బికాస్ ఇట్స్ అబౌట్ సోషల్ నీడ్ అండ్ రెస్పాన్సిబిలిటీ అండ్ సోషల్ నీడ్ అండ్ రెస్పాన్సిబిలిటీ డజంట్ నీడ్ మ్యారేజ్ ఫర్ టుడే సో ఐఎమ్ సో గ్లాడ్ దట్ యూ కేమ్ హియర్ అండ్ స్పోక్ అబౌట్ సో మెనీ థింగ్స్ అబౌట్ యు నో హెల్పింగ్ యానిమల్స్ ఫ్రమ్ యు నో ఆల్సో ఫర్ గివింగ్ మీ అ లాట్ ఆఫ్ కాంటాక్ట్స్ అస్ వెల్ ఓకే మై ఐ హావ్ అ లాట్ ఆఫ్ పీపుల్ హూ ఐమ్ గోయింగ్ టు ఇంటర్వ్యూ after you you've given me their contacts as well. They've been doing great work. Panneru Teja also joined in. I don't know if he's now there or not, but he's an animal rescuer. You've given me such great contacts. But before you end this show, there's anything you would want to say and say a bye to everybody?
I already said, right? Like, just be kind to your surroundings and be kind to people. Yeah, be kind towards the mother.
Be kind.
And that's all. And spread this.
This is needed.
You have to call it the other word actually.
Ab babi ye utta kon mehnat karega ab itte mein khush ho jao. So basically you understood, right? It's...
Now this is perfect.
Spread love, guys. We all need love. We cannot survive without love. Chahe wo mummy papa ka love ho ya bachcho ka love ho ya animal ka love ho. You know, I've seen Dheeraj being so happy when a doggy, you know, does this tail nice movement wala thing. And and you know what? Since still so many years, I didn't know that when dogs are happy, they do that. But like, I didn't know it. Imagine, I was so scared of dogs now. So I never encountered that feeling. But slowly, you inspired me in one thing, which is very important. I have to state that right here is that being okay with dogs. Like, I'm scared of them, but they are not bad. They are just... I am scared. It's my problem. It's not dog's problem. So thank you for doing that. Yeah. Yes. Yeah, spread love. Cheers to that, Raja. Thank you so much. Please say a bye and let's end this show. Thank you so much for joining in.
Spread love. Spread positivity. Just be kind. Bye bye.
Let's take a selfie. I mean, not selfie. Oh, what's happening? Let's take a screenshot. Okay.
Let's set positivity.
Yes, spread positive. But I can't do that because I need to take a screenshot.
I can take that.
Take, please.
Done.
Wow, that is so quick. I struggle with screenshots. My phone keeps moving. All right. Okay. Thank you so much. Everybody who's joined us. I said, please follow Dheeraj at I am M Dheeraj. Please follow me on @ Aditi Nagori Official. We are going to come with more inspiring people like him. He is without associating himself or having his own NGO. He's done so much in these 10 years. I request that all the 30, 40, 50 people who kept watching us continuously, please, apne taraf se bhi, me taraf nunchi kuda, chinna help, definitely jayandi. Even if for animal gaani, it's for humans gaani. So bye guys, this is Dheeraj and Aditi Nagori signing off for the day. Lots of love, love, love and spread positivity. Bye Japo Dheeraj.
Bye bye. Thank you so much, everybody. Thank you for all the positivity. Keep spreading, keep sharing love.
Yes. Bye bye, guys. Bye-bye. Thank you so much, guys, for joining in. It was a great session. We are going to come tomorrow again with People Baba. He is an environmentalist. He has, planted more than 20 million trees in our country. He's known as the tree man of our country. So I'm looking forward for this session tomorrow, which is going to be super interesting. We'll get to know some really good tips on how we can save our nature and do things in our own houses. Isn't it interesting? So thank you so much, guys. This is Aditi Nagori signing off for the day. Love. Pyar bato.